don't want to leave. Not until I find that crystal. I'm tired of being a freak. I want to have friends. I want to live a normal life. Without this curse. If that purifying crystal can make that happen, make me normal, then I'm not going back until I find it. Yeah, so? There's no going back now.
Oh fuck, are we gonna go to the fucking... Yep. The fucking part of the main game that was actually a horror game?
What's this?
Oh fuck. Fuck off. It's already starting. I have a lot of health, but not much else. Something tells me once I get to this fucking cursed place, it won't even matter. What this is. Well, let's play.
I swear I've seen these monkeys before, but what the hell?
Oh yeah, wasn't the monkey her favorite toy when she was a baby? Wasn't that one of the things?
What's wrong? Okay. What?
Oh no.
Something seems different.
Yeah, completely different elevator. Okay. You don't even go into the house. It's fucking the elevator just takes you straight to it. That is awesome, though. I kind of want this monkey. I'm not ready for this. Oh, man. Oh, that's a lot of reading.
All right, I'm going to need a drink. Be right back. I'm a little nervous and I'm kind of procrastinating doing this because this part of the main game was actually like legit scary. Alright, January 5th. Today was my first day of school. I've always wanted to go. I'm going to give Chris a big hug next time I see him. There were so many kids my age. It was like I walked into a TV show or something. How old is she supposed to be here? I was so scared when I had to introduce myself to the class, but I was still super duper excited to be there. I'm going to make so many friends. I'm going to try and talk to them tomorrow. January 8th. I tried to be brave and talk to some other kids, but no one wants to talk to me. Schoolwork is super easy. It's all stuff I learned with mommy. But I guess I shouldn't answer all the teacher's questions. The boy behind me said something really mean. My hands go icky with white sweat when I panic. It was really bad today. Gross. February 10th. Today the teacher yelled at me for always carrying my hanky. She says I'm not a baby anymore. Yo, fucking punch that teacher right in the dick. Because you sound like you're 6 years old. If a teacher yells at you for having your hanky when you're 6 years old, fucking punch him in the dick. The boys at school keep saying I'm icky, but I take a bath every night, always wear clean clothes, and bring a fresh hanky every day. It's because of the stupid white sweat. Whenever it starts coming out of my hands, I wipe it off right away. Oh, God. But sometimes it won't wipe off. So I just hold my hanky really tight. Chris even told the teacher it can't get anyone sick, but it didn't change anything. April 4th. Someone finally talked to me. Lucy from my class said she always wanted to be friends. We're going to have lunch together tomorrow. I can't believe it. I'm so happy. I hope Lucy's friend Catherine will be my friend too. Uh-oh. She killed the Moochie. Because she implied that she's accidentally killed kids before. That her powers went a little out of control sometimes.
Why is there a picture of me?
Yeah, here we fucking go. Just like the main game, they present you with the thing you need right in this room, and as soon as you pick it up, all hell breaks loose. Crystal's right there, but there's no way to get to it.
Playtime. You don't need that junk.
Hey, my stuff.
Oh, boy. And I don't get to use my powers either. Stomach has been stitched up. Looks like something's in there. Mr. Monkey has a tummy ache. He might give you the crystal if you help him. Okay. Thanks, I hate it already. At least we don't have to hide in the closets. That's a good sign. Can't open them. So hopefully I don't get chased by shit. The only thing I can guess what that's supposed to be is the giant fetus baby chasing Ethan. Maybe. Oh my god. Fucking her shadow scared me. Dudes, it's starting already, I'm telling you. I'm fucking nervous. I don't like it. I don't like it. I'm normally fine with horror games in general, but at least with like a horror game, you know what you're getting yourself into, so you know what to expect. But when like Half-Life 2 Ravenholm, for example, or like this part of the main Resident Evil 8 game, you don't really expect the horror to be like a typical horror game until you get to that one section, you know what I mean? Like Ravenholm. It's just one of those things where it's like, you build it up in your head to be just like any other shooting zombie type game, and then you get to this one section where it's just like, no, we're gonna scare the shit out of you now. And it makes it extra scary. I don't know why. Like, I can handle any horror game, but when it comes to shit like that, it's just scarier. Stuff locker, the picture on the bookshelf, the desk covered in stuff. Looks like I need a code for this one. Covered in stuff. Oh, 66. What order are they going to call them? Fuck off. It's the order that they wrote it in, right? So, 2 0 2 44 66 02 44 66 02 44 66 02
What the hell?
That's not blocked anymore.
Now.
get the crystal once you get the campfire started. Wait. This goes over here, doesn't it? Oh, everything's different. Fuck. Okay, we got Lucy. I bet you can find all kinds of places to play with this doll and her friends. Well, no, it goes there.
Someone really went all out.
That's it? That's all you have to say? That time it wasn't my shadow, and it got me a little bit less, but it still fucking got me. Fucking hell. Jimmy.
So you want me to play with dolls?
I need to clean that gross mold off her. Okay, so obviously... it's 2, 3, and 4, so I get... gotta put them here and get a third one. Stop, dude.
Yeah, I get it. Fuck it.
Thank you. No kidding. Why did it have to be mannequins this time? I expected you to be right there. Got Rose, but not me that time. Typewriter. Can I save? No.
Jeez, Rose, you're still looking for the crystal? Fine. I'll help you out. Take the elevator, please. Mommy might be upset that I'm helping you, though.
Who are you?
Let's play statues. I don't like statues. It's not a fun game. Just leave.
Thank you.
Oh, fuck, I don't like this. Oh my god, this is so fucked up. I hate it. I hate it so much. Oh, there's one right behind me. Ah! So, okay. As soon as I pick up the thing, what do I gotta do?
Jesus Christ!
I just kinda gotta, like, get them both in my line of sight, right? And then book it, and then cut this way. Oh. Oh, what the hell? Ah, what the hell? How do I get rid of her? Oh my god.
Ugh, won't this thing work?
Fuck you.
Why aren't you doing this?
You're after the crystal, aren't you?
Do you know where it is?
I've gathered some friends just for you. Entertain them, and maybe I'll tell.
What's going on here?
Aw, I'm tiny.
Poor little Rose. I'm waiting for you in the back bedroom.
Back bedroom? Let's play hide and seek. Can you make it all the way here without getting caught? Oh, probably not. Oh boy.
Okay, so it's just stealth? I fucking hope so. Yeah, just stay out of their light, I guess, right? Oh! Fucking hell. Guess I got too close.
I guess I should keep heading this way?
Okay, so you're allowed one mistake. Flashlight is kind of throwing me off though, because I can't tell if it's theirs or mine. They don't seem to hear you. Right? It's only the light. Or if I get too close, like I just did. This music, it's like, it's really reminding me of like Little Nightmares type situation. But what path did that open though?
Yourself, Jobber.
Oh,
this way.
Well, there's still plenty of friends
You fools! This is creepy as fuck, but it's far less scary than what I had to go through with those fucking mannequins.
Just have to get past them.
The desk or two. Michael. I need you, Michael. Oh. Oh. Shit, I didn't think I'd survive that. Where did you come from? Faster than this, Rose. What? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Man! What the fuck? To do.
Gotta get out of here.
Is there a way I'm supposed to like stall it? I think she broke through the door too quick last time. Michael!
I can't take much more of this. Why are they talking about my dad? I never even met him. No. I don't know. I don't know the first thing about him. I wish I did. All I know is...
See, why would Michael ask that if he's not Ethan?
Sometimes I try to imagine what my life would have been like if he hadn't died. They've taught me to ride a bike, helped me with my homework, told me a story every night. Would he have been there for me? Proud of me? Sometimes I feel lost or afraid. Try to imagine what he might have said to me.
Or maybe it's like something on the other side that knows Ethan personally.
Where are we? Feels familiar, like I've been here before. Look at all the decorations.
Yeah, Michael even brought me to my house when I was a baby. To do: decorate the living room. Done. Get wine, put in dining room. Yep. Rose's other present and study. Hidden. Alright.
She's so little. Hard to believe one day she'll be old enough to share a bottle of wine with her old man.
What's that voice? Is that... Dad? This must be my parents' house from when I was a baby. I bet... other things also have my dad's memories.
She bangs her spoon every time I play this. I wonder if she'll be a musician.
I wonder if Dad played any instruments.
She just cannot get enough of this stuff.
I bet Dad would feed me as soon as I started crying.
Is Michael trying to say something? Take your time and look around. That's what I'm doing, Mike.
Rose is such a picky eater. All she ever wants is fruit puree.
I guess I've always loved fruit. Upstairs? Take a look.
This tune has always been special for our family.
I think I've heard this before. It's pretty.
Jeez, did your mom not keep anything? Fuck. What a comfy little nook. Ethan, don't forget Rose's half-birthday is on the 2nd. I'm going to make an amazing cake, so you better eat it. In fact, I'm going to make a cake for every special occasion we have. I want you to take lots of pictures for our family album.
I haven't seen Mom in ages.
Ha. It's one of the Resi 7 collectibles. It's my room! Man, they didn't give a fuck!
I know. She's probably a little too young for this, but it was too cute.
I wonder how we played with this.
It's a fucking baby's first D&D die.
She's growing so fast, getting bigger every day.
This crib is so little.
She's already growing out of these onesies?
I can't believe I was ever this tiny.
Those look bigger than the baby that was around, you know, when Ethan died.
I wonder if she'll look like me when she grows up.
Oh, I looked so happy.
You did? That baby's not even smiling. February 2nd is Rose's half birthday. Half a year in the blink of an eye. I wanted to capture this moment, these feelings, so I wrote something special. It may have gotten a bit sappy, though. I'd feel embarrassed if anyone stumbles across it, so it's safe in the sideboard for now. The key is behind my favorite photo.
Letter for me?
Happy half birthday, Rose. My gift to you is a promise. I'll always be there for you, no matter what. I'll be there every birthday to watch you blow out the candles on your cake. I'll be there to make you breakfast and walk you to school every day. I'll be there when you have a bad dream and sing to you until you fall back asleep. I'll hug you tight when you're troubled or worried and tell you that everything's gonna be all right. You are my precious Rose. Never forget that, Dad.
No one loves you.
Oh, shit.
No! Michael! Michael, help! Michael! No!
The fuck you doing here? Oh, man, was she Michael and just trolling her the whole time?
Guess what? That thing you're looking for isn't here.
So, you don't have the purifying crystal?
Of course not. For that, you'll have to go deeper. Much deeper.
Poor Rose.
She can't trust anyone.
Why are you doing this?
No one loves you. And when you're dead, no one will care! Enough. Drown.
Oh god.
Keep first.
Ah, you bitch.
Why does she only want you?
What are you talking about?
Oh, you're jealous that Mia loves me.
You are beyond worthless! Seriously, what is your problem?
Sure am. No, I'm being Death Stranded. Oh my god, those are so horrific.
Enough of
this. Now, you'll
drown.
Sisters.
She only wants you. What are you talking about? Look at you. You are beyond worthless. Seriously, what is your problem?
I mean, that's a good question, Rose. I just gotta wait for this to go away. There we go. What's this? Bunch of white sage.
Just so.
Eat a dick! Ah! Ow, 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 ow! Get out! Ah! Get the fuck out of here! Because I'm the special
Michael.
One, bitch.
Good, you made it out. Evelyn? That little girl?
You must know who Evelyn is.
You got pissed off at that one guy for calling you Evelyn before. Try. Help, but it's weak. Ooh. Thanks, Daddy. Who I'm assuming is Daddy.
Never.
Oh, well, I don't think I got it, Dad. Get it. Just like at the end of 7. Lost child. Nobody likes you. Ah. Shit. Oh fuck, I thought she already did it. Aw, Michael. You're sweet.
Give up, Rose. Find that crystal.
Michael? Are you there?
Rose, look out!
He saved me. But he didn't make it. That voice. My dad's voice. Is Michael?
Don't give up, Rose. Find that crystal.
Because of him, I can keep going. I have to find that crystal.
Well, someone better pick up that phone.
I'm on my own, but I have to keep going.
Because I fucking called it.
Doing out here?
Ooh, I get my shit back? Hell yeah. They did the clever thing with the jacket and blonde hair, right? Makes you think.
Just
like the werewolf versions are. Are they the same from the castle, just like more shredded up? Here's the statue. God. I'm fighting zombie me's. The ones behind me better not get up. That would be some bullshit. Rose.
I need to find that crystal.
It's the Mega by Siege.
Mega Mycete absorbs the memories of all life within its reach, but there are laws which govern this world within it. It seems worthwhile to catalog them as they become apparent. 1. The memories that comprise this realm do not strictly reflect reality. Gee, you think? 2. Only those who are attuned to the Mega Mycete in life retain control of their faculties here in this realm. This aligns with my understanding of the Mega Mycete as revealed to me in its visions before my death. Someone's been here. Yes, my death. My physical body is gone, absorbed into the Mega Mycete, and yet I do not despair, for this fate has granted me fascinating insights. All those years I strived, have continued to strive, they are not for nothing. The memories, the consciousness, understanding, and knowledge I accumulated in life have transferred here to the Mega Mycete, where it serves as a source of power within this realm. If I can harness this power, I believe I can use it to affect the thoughts and memories of others. Of course, it's hardly a perfect arrangement, with so many minds and memories gathered here. Finding and retrieving a single person from amidst the rabble has proven an immense challenge. Memories are here, yes, but dissolute. Perhaps what is needed is the right vessel into which to hold her. And of course, I know of the perfect vessel. The only real candidate in all my years of searching, Rosemary Winters.
Someone's been here.
Alright.
Oh boy. I had intended to duplicate Rosemary Winters with the hope that a perfect replica might serve as a suitable vessel. However, the results were less than ideal. It would seem that some sort of interference has prevented me from creating a suitable replica.
Excuse me.
Instead, I have succeeded in making what is essentially a living doll. It resembles the real thing, yes, but has no power. Such a pathetic husk can never prove suitable as a vessel. I will continue my efforts in hopes of discerning the source of this interference. Several hypotheses have come to mind thus far. One, the fact that Rose herself is still alive. Two, some other actor within this realm. Three, a flaw in my methods of production. None of these seem especially likely to be the sole reason, nor are any of them easy problems to solve. Perhaps my best hope is to somehow bring Rose into this realm. Were she to offer herself as a vessel, it would be so simple. Uh-oh. Additional observations. Further experiments with these Rose copies, as I've taken to calling these husks, have yielded another interesting wrinkle to pursue. When subjected to situations evoking extreme terror, they actually begin to express some semblance of Rose's abilities. This warrants more research, and I think that my first creation, the Masked Duke, is just the one to perform this stress test.
They couldn't have been watching me the entire time.
Oh fuck, they're setting me up for a boss fight. It would seem that at some point during my experiments with consciousnesses, an intruder made herself at home in my realm. This intruder was none other than the failure Evelyn, who has been running around enacting her own pitiful agenda, which has led to a slight disruption in my own plans. Had Evelyn not interfered, Rosemary Winters would have been on the verge of despair, dispossessed of her will to live and her mutamycete powers. Instead, a new passion burns within her. I shall have to extinguish it. Oh my god, they're giving me so much ammo, dude. Oh no.
Must be the crystal. I'm almost there. Michael,
Dad, Michael. That pull I've been feeling is close, but I just can't go any further. I thought I had made it when I saw that blue light, but no, not quite. If only I'd been braver, faster, stronger. So close, I was so close. Oh wait, I totally forgot. Oh, for fuck's sakes. I haven't been reading her diary. Shit. Deeper stratum. That masked lunatic's crystal was a fake. I can't believe I went through all that for nothing. Now we're in a deeper stratum, and Michael says it'll be harder to leave, but I'm not going back. I refuse to be called a freak ever again. You freak! Seems like I finally got through to Michael about that. He actually said he'd help me look for the crystal, which caught me off guard after all of this go-home-give-up nonsense in the castle. Now it feels like we're a team. Dad's voice. Those dolls were just unspeakably awful. Thank God Michael found me and got us out of there. The moment he brought me here, I felt better, and not just because I'm my usual size. I think this is actually the memory of my parents' old house.
That's another parallel to her and Alice in Wonderland, right? Shrinking down. I mean, you can say that about a lot of things, but I just find it interesting that this is very Alice in Wonderland, right? But like American McGee's, like it's just like the fucked up version. I don't remember this place myself, but it seems to be brimming with memories of my dad. I can really feel his love for me and how much hope he had for my future. Evelyn. According to Michael, oh, that picture of her though, oof. According to Michael, the girl that's been terrorizing me is named Evelyn. I have no idea why, but she absolutely hates my guts. I should have seen this coming after that masked creep, but he was also lying about the crystal. Fool me once. But none of that matters now. I'm going to get this mold out of me. I'm going to get my friends. I'm going to get friends, and I'm going to be normal. Is this before the ending to the main game? Is this where she learns about Evelyn, and then after this is over, she wants to visit her father's grave, and that's when that cutscene takes place? That cutscene takes place after all this? Because that would make so much more sense. That would actually explain quite a bit. Rainy news. Michael pushed me out of the way. I think I've lost count of the number of times he saved me now. I don't know what happened to him back there, but I have to press on. I have to find that crystal. I know he'd want me to. This place isn't like anywhere else I've been. Those at least felt like they could exist in reality, but this is different. A strange sky dotted with those with these creepy black orbs. Dripping ooze all and all sorts of random junk. I didn't see random junk. Unless the shit on the ground that was like from the castle came out of those, but like I didn't think of that. I don't know why she did. I have no idea where this is, but I do know the crystal's here somewhere. I can sense it. Rainy news. That says it again. Okay. They're all cut up.
Through here.
Black God, which lives in us and in which we live. Create for us a new world as benefits your will. Your dark consciousness holds for us a second grace. Second chance, oh my God. Graciously offered and joyously accepted. You drink the blood of the lost lamb as it falls upon your darkened earth, not to destroy, but to preserve, and once again deliver unto life.
This is some twisted shit.
Boss fight. All right, now wake up and get out of here. Quickly.
Oh my God. Is this what normal feels like?
Feeling she'd be coming back.
Rose, I've waited so long for you.
Who are you?
My name is Moran.
What?
You had become so powerful. Far too powerful for me to subdue directly. So, I had to lure you into this realm so that you might willingly use your powers.
No, but Kay said...
Did he? Or did I? Was an illusion. Very convincing, wouldn't you say?
No way.
Now you can become the vessel for my Eva!
Rose, run!
Ethan, you pest!
Go!
He can manifest. He can save you, Rose! No one can. Rose!
Oh.
You can't.
Holy shit. Fucking daddy. I'm too slow, Dad. I mean, that's fair.
And I'm sorry I left you alone, but I had to find a way out. And I did. It's just ahead.
Rose!
Yes? What? Daddy?
Get away! Stay away from my family!
They're still trying to hide his face. We all know what he looks like.
You can't escape, Rose. Ethan, persistent as always.
Dad!
Rose, now's your chance. Go live a normal life. Make friends. No one will ever call you a freak again.
But...
Rose, just go!
I don't want to leave you!
I know. I love you. But I need to know you're safe. So please, just...
Ethan, you insolent pest!
I got this. Get out of here.
Yeah, he's killed her once before. Oh, God. Damn it, Dad! Yeah, I had a feeling that something would happen where she'd find her powers to be more useful, but she'd learn to control them better while she was here. I kind of saw that coming. Which would add to that cutscene at the end of the base game where she's at the graveyard. When she tells the security guard that, like, I can do things that even Chris doesn't know I can do. For that cutscene to take place after this would make even more sense that she doesn't give up her powers at all.
With how intent you were on my throwing them away?
Whoa, I could do fucking sick corpse. I'm turning into Wesker. Oh, cool.
This is...
Ow.
And even if you were to survive, what would be in the doubt? You can't save your father.
Oh, that's not...
You are of two different worlds.
Fucking sick, dude. She's getting so OP.
Don't. How about this?
Yeah, how about it? Huh? Huh?
Why suffer needs?
Oh, I was trying to do the punch, but I guess I don't have enough. Hold forward and press P, that's why. And then she dodges.
There's nothing.
Oh, come on. Oh, bitch. Didn't see that one coming, did ya? You gave it to me.
Do you still miss?
Not intentionally.
There is no happy ending.
Your suffering will never end! You just won't give up. You really are.
Oh dear.
Makes you perfect best.
Bitch!
What is this?
Real power. That's what.
Don't resist.
My power now.
Rose, don't get too cocky.
Won't let you do this.
Impossible. I shall finish this. There is no victory. My struggle comes to fruition.
Rose! Over here!
Dad!
Do you have an all-powerful weapon for me, Dad? That can really help right now.
Use this. Take her down.
Oh, shit. Kamehameha! Oh, you're so fucking dead!
You truly would have been the perfect vessel for my evil!
I'm not a goddamn vessel. Not some stupid copy. I mean, Rose. And you're done.
Hey, sweetie.
Oh my God!
You're so grown up now. Even though I wasn't there with you, I always watched over you. I'm so sorry I couldn't protect you.
All you've ever done is protect me.
No. Not this time. You lost your chance. I'm so sorry.
No. It was my choice. And I don't regret it one bit. I loved you. We never would have had this chance to talk face to face. So it's okay. I'm okay.
I'm so proud of you. very proud of you. I love you, Rose.
He's fucking... These excuses to cover his face is just ridiculous.
I'm back.
Are you, though? I would have such a hard time dealing with reality after something like that.
I'm back.
Yeah, here it is.
Do you think the little boy will be able to touch the moon?
Nobody can touch the moon. It's too far away.
Wait, what if he has a rocket ship?
Okay, then you can touch it, but it'd be very, very cool.
Yeah, that makes perfect sense. Silly. Having this cutscene come after this DLC makes so much more sense. Although it also kind of makes the DLC kind of pointless because we've already seen how it ends.
We have a situation. You're needed, Evelyn.
Don't you ever call me that again.
Whoa. Whoa, it's just a joke, Rose.
I can show you things even Chris doesn't know I can do.
We have a clear shot.
Stand down.
We have a clear shot. That's the best part.
She's just a kid.
There's a fucking sniper out there that's just always aiming at her.
Him, you know.
I know.
Okay, and then we see this mysterious figure walking, which out of bounds camera YouTube videos have showed that it is actually Ethan. So I want to see if this cutscene gets extended. Now that we know that. Same fucking way. Just play the same cutscene that we've already seen. All in all, that was pretty good though. For like a little, you know, 3 to 4 hour DLC. Not bad. Yeah, so my completion was 249. But I've been streaming for 350. So, depending on how you consider it, game time would be about 3 hours. Real time would be about 4.
and gives you some challenges. Cool. Well, that was Shadows of Rose. See these challenges. Finish it on casual, finish it on standard. Gotta do it on hardcore still. Got those at least 20 times, at least 80 times. Defeat 50 enemies with a handgun. I got 36. Defeat 30 enemies with a shotgun, I got 8. Read every single file. I missed 3 files? Oh, I was looking so hard for them too. Complete it in under an hour 30 minutes. I feel like that would be pretty easy. Fight through the pain, complete Shadow of Rose without using any first aid med. When Rose is small, make it back to the study without being hit by the dolls. Listen to all of Ethan's memories in a single playthrough. Listen to his memories? Huh. Summon the Mega Mycete at least 5 times in a single fight with Miranda. Summon the Mega Mycete at least 5 times? Is that like the punch to the ground? I feel like I did that at least 5 times, didn't I? Achieve all the challenges, which are these. I have 7 out of 16 total. Cool. Give me some replayability, right? Okay, then. Well, thank you so much for joining, as always, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye!